When you want to develop your arms, training triceps is key. Last week we looked into bicep training, but now it's time to see how you can train the other side of your arms. For most people, the triceps are bigger than the biceps. The tricep is a three-headed muscle that generally has a greater growth potential than the two-headed bicep muscle. So if growing bigger arms is the goal, your triceps deserve extra attention. To keep this video very practical, I will first start by discussing the anatomy of the triceps and then look into exercises you can use to train all the heads of your tricep muscle. Now, as mentioned, the tricep is a three-headed muscle. All heads of your triceps act to realize elbow extension. This happens when you move your lower arm towards your body. So it's clear why exercises like tricep pushdowns and skull crushers are popular for training triceps. These exercises all train elbow extension. But anatomically, there's another thing we need to consider when it comes to training your triceps. The long head of your triceps, which is also the biggest head, crosses your shoulder joint. This means that shoulder position affects how well the long head of your tricep is trained. So to train your triceps, and particularly the long head, at different muscle lengths, it's a good idea to train your triceps from different angles. I want to show you three tricep exercises I use with many of my clients to train for complete tricep development. Per exercise, I'll also show you an alternative just in case you don't like the given tricep exercise that I show. First, we have rope tricep pushdowns. Something you may notice is that I use two ropes at the same time to create a longer attachment. This is to train the long head of your triceps harder, because when you use a longer attachment, you can extend your arms slightly behind your body. The long head of the triceps then get a greater contraction and your triceps go through a greater range of motion. With a regular rope, your range of motion is pretty much limited and you can't move your arms behind your body. If your gym has only one rope that you can make use of, then you can improve the resistance curve of one rope tricep pushdowns by leaning a bit forward during the exercise. This way, your hips don't inhibit you from using full range of motion. As an alternative for the rope pushdown, you can also do cable kickbacks. With this exercise, it's easy to train your triceps while your arms are behind your body. You'll feel a good peak contraction at the top of the lift since then your triceps are fully shortened. I would strongly suggest using cables and not dumbbell kickbacks, since dumbbell kickbacks do not place good tension on your triceps throughout the range of motion. So we just covered an exercise in which you train your triceps while your arms are at your side. Now it's time to look into training your triceps from a different angle, specifically while your arms are over your head. We can accomplish this with the one arm overhead extension. I like doing this with one arm since it allows you to focus on training each arm individually. This trains your triceps more while they are in a stretched position. You want to focus on keeping your upper arms as perpendicular to the floor as possible and only moving your lower arm up. A common mistake people make is that they let their elbows point outward too much, which takes away tension from the triceps. An alternative to this exercise is the dumbbell skull crusher. With this exercise, you also train the triceps while your shoulder is in a more flexed position. Before starting the skull crusher, I suggest you move your arm slightly back in about a 70 to 80 degree angle. By doing this, there is tension on the triceps also when your elbow is completely extended. Now that I've covered isolation exercises for your triceps, let's take a step back and go back to the basis of bicep training, and that is your compound push movements. Like how exercises like pull-ups and rows grow your biceps, heavy push exercises like bench press and shoulder presses also develop your triceps. If you would like to focus more on your triceps during a push workout, you can consider adding an exercise like close grip bench press. With a close grip, I don't mean having your hands exactly next to each other, but more like having your hands shoulder width apart. Also, when lowering down the weight, you don't have to touch your chest per se. Stopping with the bar a few inches from your chest is enough when it comes to training your triceps. If you're not a close grip bench press fan, then you can also incorporate dips. Even weighted dips if you can do 10 plus rep bodyweight dips. To hit your triceps more during dips, you can try staying somewhat more upright. If you lean forward, your chest comes into play a lot more. So to put all of today's tips into practice, You want a tricep exercise in which you extend your elbows while your arms are next or slightly behind you. You also want to train elbow extension while your shoulder is flexed. And make sure to incorporate compound movements that emphasize the triceps, like close grip benching or dips. If you have these three movements in your training week, you're well on your way in terms of developing your triceps. The compound movements like close grip bench press and dips can be heavier and around 6 to 10 reps per set. For tricep isolation work like pushdowns, I suggest staying with 8 to 15 reps per set. And that's pretty much it for today's video. If you found this helpful, then leave me a thumbs up. Also subscribe to this channel to stay informed about effective training and nutrition. And also, as you may have noticed, my setting is slightly different. I have a crazy ghost behind me. It's basically just the way the lighting is set up. But I hope you found this video still helpful, and I hope to see you in the next one.